Hello and welcome to today's Daily Market Update. My name is Craig Earle, I'm market analyst at Alpari UK. Earlier on today, we saw a little bit of profit taking following yesterday's ECB monetary stimulus that it announced with the rate cuts across the board and also in the introduction of the purchasing of asset-backed securities. Now, we went through these yesterday, so I'm not going to go into too much details on this, but we did see a big positive reaction in the markets yesterday. And given the fact that we had the release of the US jobs report today, something that many people view as the most important economic release of every month, it was no surprise really to see that little bit of profit taken early in the session already, even though, like I said, the announcement only came less than 24 hours ago. But like I say, today the big focus has been the release of that US jobs report. Now, this is always the biggest economic release of every month, as I've already said. But then the closer we get to those Federal Reserve meetings, when we know we're going to see at some point soon some change in monetary policy. Now, over the last few years, of course, that's been either rate cuts or it's been quantitative easing programs. But now we're talking about a rate hike. So people are getting a little bit nervous in the markets. It's why when we're trading at these record highs in terms of indices, we are seeing these massive resistance levels. But now we're nearing that rate cut. Now, at the moment, the markets are pricing in the middle of the next year. And that is because that's based purely on the hints that the Fed has given us so far. But people are watching this data very closely. We're looking for signs or any reason why the Fed could change its mind and become a little less dovish and start to maybe talk about an earlier interest rate hike. And these are the type of things that are going to have a real impact on the markets in the months ahead. And the non-farm payrolls, well, the US jobs report as a whole has the potential to have that big impact. Now, for me personally, I'm looking at these data points and I'm thinking, well, the unemployment rate is at, well, until today was at 6.2%, very close now to the level that the Fed deems full employment. This is between 5.2 and 5.5%. This is where the Fed deems with the US economy as being at full employment. So we're getting very close to that level now. And the Fed itself has talked about the labour market and said that things are improving in terms of the unemployment rate. And now it's focusing more on things like productivity, focusing on wage growth, focusing on the ability of people who are working part-time to get full-time work. There's still a lot of people in the US who are working part-time, but they want to be working full-time. They talk about the ability to walk out of one job and move into another. Basically, they're talking about the way things were before the recession hit back in 2008. And they're saying that there's still areas that aren't back to normal, effectively. Now, when you're looking at the jobs report today, then for me, if they're happy with the unemployment rate as it is, then the unemployment rate and the non-farm payrolls figures are not the most important pieces of data that are being released. We've got to look at the average weekly hours worked. We've got to look at the average hourly wage. These are the things which I think the Fed are going to be more focused on right now. But at the moment, the markets are still very much focused on the unemployment rate. They're still very much focused on the participation rate. They're still very much focused on the non-farm payrolls figures. These are the things which are still getting the biggest reactions in the markets. Now, once we start to get that less dovish tone from the Federal Reserve, once they drop a bit of the language from their statements that would suggest they're going to continue with this loose monetary policy, and I'm talking about the fact that they're saying that rates are going to stay low for this for a sustained amount of time, then once they start to drop this language, then I think we're going to start to see more of a reaction to these smaller pieces of data, the average hourly hours, the average hourly wage. That's when we're going to start to see more attention on these. Now, today we have seen a bit of a negative reaction in the market to this jobs report. There's a couple of, there's two reasons, I think, reason for this. Firstly, the one that really stands out is the non-farm payrolls figure. This fell to 142,000 last month. This is the first month this year since January or since December that we've actually had a non-farm payrolls figure below 200,000 now. Ordinarily, you think, well, this is not a great figure. But we had six consecutive months prior to this where the numbers were above 200,000. That was the first time since before 2008. So really, what we've actually become accustomed to this year has not been normal from what we've become accustomed to over the last 6 or 7 years. This has actually been a very good year of job creation. So the fact that we've had this drop to 142,000, I don't necessarily think is a bad thing. This is just one of those things that happens. We've had six very good months, and occasionally you do get a bad month of economic data. And I think that's one of the ways the market has taken it, because despite the fact that we've seen a bit of a negative response, it's not been really that negative response. The US indices are trading mildly in negative territory. We've seen a little bit of dollar weakness, but nothing excessive. I think people have taken it as it is in one bad month of data. I don't think people are too overly concerned at this stage. But despite the fact that we had that poor number in the non-farm payrolls figure, we did see a drop in the unemployment rate from 6.2% to 6.1%. And I think this is largely driven from a drop in the participation rate from 62.9% to 62.8%. Again, nothing to be concerned about. It's a 0.1% drop. We've had improvements in the participation rate in recent months. But I think that is what is accounting for, despite the fact that we've had poor jobs growth in the previous month, that's why I think we've seen the drop in the unemployment rate, is because of that drop in participation. So all in all, a bit of a mixed jobs report, probably slightly weaker than we were hoping for. But again, I think one thing that we've learned today is this is why you can't necessarily really trust the ADP figure in terms of being a good estimate of non-farm payrolls, because the ADP figure really was not even close to what we've seen today. It really didn't work. It turned out to be a great estimate. But overall, like I say, not a great jobs report, but not a horrible one either. And I think given the fact that this is just a one-off following six great jobs reports, I don't think people are too concerned. I think the US is still on for a strong recovery. The rest of the data we've seen this week has been very good. Both ISM reports, the non-manufacturing PMI and the manufacturing PMI reports have both been very strong. The weekly jobless claims were back around 300,000. All in all, aside from today's figures, the US figures have been very good, and they have pointed to a strong recovery. They've pointed to a sustainable recovery, and I think these are the things which are going to stick in people's heads. I don't think people are going to be too concerned about today. We just need to see those improvements in other areas of the economy, particularly wage growth and particularly productivity, and I think then we can start to talk more seriously about Fed hikes. For more news and analysis, check out the Alpari newsroom at alpari.co.uk/newsroom. And you can also check us out on Twitter. Also, don't forget to sign up for next week's webinar. It takes place Tuesday, 12:30 to 1:30. There's a sign-up link on the screen right now. Alternatively, you can also see another link on the newsroom website. Thank you very much for listening. Have a great weekend. My name's Craig Earl, a market analyst at Alpari UK.